Hello, my name is Ioan Mihai Robert. I'm a trainer for SC Psycho4World in Erasmus Project Young Ethical Leaders. Today we'll speak about the second course, which is the interview job. We'll begin with EuroPass, or creating my resume. Job loss is not something anyone would want, but especially in recent years, the number of unemployed people around the world has increased significantly. The effects of the economic crisis have led to a decrease in the number of jobs, an expansion of the range of candidates available as a result of restructuring, and last but not least, an increase in the demands of employers in relation to employees. The competition for a job is getting fiercer. It is very important to have accurate and complete information on alternatives and employment opportunities. This means initiating a sustained effort to go through all the sources of information in the field, the specialized press, the internet, and recruitment agencies. So finding a job requires time, patience, and effort. It is absolutely necessary that the choice of the job takes into account your own inclination and abilities, the condition and requirements of the desired job. This guide is intended to be a help for a job seeker and contains base elements on how to draw up a CV, a letter of intent that we need to create in search of a job. In order to increase the chances of getting a job, or at least a job interview, is to prepare a professional file containing the CV, a letter of intent, letters of recommendation, and other documents like copies of personal documents regarding seniority in work, evidence related to professional affiliations, example of products of the activity. Okay, well-organized and structured file of the person looking for a job is a proof of a sense of responsibility and an image advantage in the eyes of the employers. When considering a job application, the employer needs a minimum of information about the person in question. So anyone looking for a job will need to learn to write a short biography called CV. The CV is your business card based on which the employer makes a first impression. Most often, the right to appear for an interview is earned through a quality resume. General recommendation for compiling a CV is present your qualification skills and competences clearly and logical so that person attributes are highlighted. Pay close attention to every relevant detail, both in substance and form. And a good resume depends not only on what you write, how you present, what you say is just as important. The CV would be good if it would cover about 2 or 3 pages, not contain grammatical or expression errors, contain a clear and easy to follow text with a general present and attractive appearance. The font chosen should be sober and not too small, but not too big. Paragraphs should not be too long because they are difficult to follow. The important titles should be marked in bold and the information should be arranged in a logical order following a chronological, functional, or oriented criterion. Necessary include general data such as name, address, telephone, and email address specified from the beginning. Contain keywords appropriate to the job, not contain distributing repetitions. It would be desirable to use action indicating verbs such as develop, lead, or destiny to emphasize achievements and not declarative sentences such as I participated, as I assisted at, and on maybe to avoid passive constructions such as I was responsible for. The standard structure of a professional CV includes the following elements. Photography, it is an important element. The second one is personal data. The information presented in this chapter must be complete and accurate as possible in order to correspond to the data in the identity documents and graduation diplomas. Name and surname, date and place of birth, address, email address, phone number, and marital status and nationality. Target career and job objectives formulated according to the job you are aiming for or the area you want to work in. Education. If you do not have much professional experience, it is advisable to highlight all the studies and diplomas obtained. However, you have a long experience in a certain field, this is more appreciated than a study done in that field. The fifth one is practical internships. Completion and deepening of theoretical education, and which allows the accumulation of practical skills very useful in the training of the candidate. Usually the related time interval, the company, and the purpose of the internship must be mentioned there. The sixth one is professional experience, the strong point of the CV, a summary of professional development, which must highlight the knowledge gained through practical experiences. It is very important to reveal what you have done in that position and the results you have achieved. The information in this chapter should be as complete and concise as possible. It is necessary to specify the time interval, the company or the institution, the position held, the position and the attributes you had, and if you had special results, it is a good thing that they are mentioned. Okay, and the seventh one is published works, optional elements of the CV. The eighth one is knowledge and skills known foreign languages and computer skills, as well as other aspects in which you excel and wish would be useful for the job. The ninth one is extra professional activities. Some say that it is good to write in the CV any hobby you have because it denotes interest, dedication, and involvement in what you do and what you like. The tenth one is miscellaneous, like driving license, salary claims, and the final one is references and recommendation. The second thing in this course is cover letter or the letter of intent. When hiring, the file must contain, along with the CV and references, a letter of intent to communicate to the employer who you are and why you send the CV. A letter of intent should complete a resume, not duplicate it. Its purpose is to interpret a CV that is rather data-oriented and more factual and to add personal accent. The letter of intent must be personalized for each position. It can make the difference between getting an interview and ignoring your resume. So it's very important to pay close attention to what you write your cover letters. Structure of the letter of intent. The first one is the section with your contact details, top right, name, address, city, postcode, phone number, email address, and date of preparation. The second one is employer contact information if available, name, title, company, and address. The third one is greeting formula, which is very important. The fourth one is the actual content of the letter of intent must stimulate the interest of the employer and lead him to read the CV attached to it. The title address should be concise, clear, relevant. It should not exceed one page. 3-4 short and concise paragraphs being sufficient. Information on why you are writing. Mention the position you are applying for and where you found out about it. Include the name of a common contact who can give reference. The next section of the letter of intent should describe what you have to offer the employer. Mention explicitly how your qualification match the job you are applying for. Conclude the letter of intent by thanking the employer for considering your application. Include information about how you can be contacted for an interview or meeting or what you intend to do next. And the fifth one, honorable conclusion and signature. And I have some suggestions for writing a letter of intent. Don't exceed one page. Write concise paragraphs. Paragraphs will have to be limited to 4 or 5 sentences and they should be short. Typewritten the letter on the computer. Use quality paper. Send it in manuscript when requested. Avoid colored paper. Do not send photos unless necessary. Ask a friend to read the letter to give you suggestions or correct mistakes. Present the reason for the request and the position or field you are targeting. Explain what aroused your interest in the job and the company. Make reference to the attached CV and try not to repeat the information. Be available for an interview and specify when you are available, including your photo, phone number and contact times. And with thanks for the time given by the interview and with your appreciations, consideration for him or her. And the essential points of the letter must be in line with the purpose of the letter. The next one is online or email application. Sending the application online or by email is a common practice, given that employers choose online recruitment tools such as requirement sites, the company's career page, social networks, etc. If signed, application must be sent by email. First thing you should do is the subject of the email should be worded clearly and precisely so that the CV and the cover letter reach the right place. The CV and the cover letter reach the right place in the email box of the person in charge of that recruitment project. The second one should be attachments. CV, cover letter. Format after writing your CV and cover letter. It is recommended that these documents be saved in PDF format and attached to the email. It is essential that each document sent to the employer be named so that the letter knows that it is a CV and to whom it belongs. To name your resume, use your first and last name. Avoid accented or special characters and spaces. For the name of the cover letter, also use the cover letter and the first and last name. Size. If your resume, photos, or logo, make sure that the total file size does not exceed 500 kilobytes. And the third one is general presentation of the application by email. The application file must be taken care of. Now let's go for recommendations for other documents. Depending on the specific profession you are considering, other documents and materials can be added to the professional file that confirm the veracity of the information presented in the CV, like documents regarding seniority in work, work card, individual employment contracts, certificates of seniority in employment. The next one is copies of personal documents regarding vocational education and training, study documents, certificates of continuous professional training, evidence related to professional affiliations, evidence related to specific skills, examples of products of the activity. Sometimes a portfolio can become very bulky with a whole host of items. In an interview, it would be inadvisable to present each of the materials to the interviewer. A better strategy would be to select a few of them and make a smaller portfolio for the interview. The portfolio can be used to point out certain aspects during the interview that are relevant to the position or promotion in question. Now let's go to conclusions. Many job seekers complain that they apply daily for dozens of vacancies and yet do not receive any invitation to the interview. For those in this situation, we recommend that they put themselves in the employer's place for a few moments. They receive several hundred CVs from which they must find the perfect employee. The question is, what do you do to be selected? Why would he choose you? In most cases, applications follow two simple steps. Select their resume and choose one of the letters of intent that would suit them and send them. It is not exactly the right strategy, being one that does not really ensure your chances to get in front of the employer. The best prepared will get the much desired job. Just as producers are trying to find something to get them out of the crowd, as you should try to differentiate yourself from the rest of the candidates when you write a resume, a letter of intent, or when you participate in an interview. First, think about what makes you unique, what differentiates you from other candidates applying for the same position, what can you offer and other candidates can't, and what is the sole reason why the employer should choose you and not another candidate. Remember, it is not the strongest who win, but the one who adapts better. Now, let's go to the subject about interview by phone. Usually a candidate goes through a series of interviews and tests. Regarding the stages that the candidate goes through before receiving the desired job, very often there are three interviews. The first one is the pre-selection interview, which tests a large number of candidates to see how many of them are compatible with the organization's position and values. The discussion is led by a human resource specialist, and many companies choose the quick version of the telephone interview, which contains some standard questions. The second interview puts the candidate face to face with the person in charge of the department in which the position for which he is in the interview is located. It is a more relaxed discussion in which the classic questions are combined with those arising from the answers provided by the candidate, and in which the employer is interested in discovering the candidate's personality, not just the professional success. The third interview presents the candidate of the person who runs the company. Only the best candidates always reach this stage. Many managers are very attentive to the potential and personality of a candidate and can give a chance to someone who does not have all the necessary training. If they discover in that person other qualities, they consider it important. The fourth one is the job interview. How to prepare for the job interview. Carefully review the edit is important for the person to be able to thoroughly prepare answers to potential employer questions. Create a list of the questions we expect to receive from the employer and another with the most important achievements and qualities, which are not necessarily found in CV. Start with the list of strengths. Employers may also ask you to talk about your weaknesses or failures and the lessons you have learned from such experiences, and you need to give honest answers that do not put you in a negative light. Find out details about the company's activity and job requirements. Do a short rehearsal before the interview so that you can get rid of the last emotions. Try to adopt a natural and friendly attitude, which will help you gain the interviewer's sympathy and relax and turn the whole discussion into a conversation. Prepare the right clothes. The interview outfit is the classic office outfit, slightly sober in neutral colors. The most indicated colors are black, blue, and gray, while orange seems to be the least recommended for the interview outfit. Take a diary and a writing tool with you. It will be useful during the discussions with the employer. Remember to write down the contact details of the place where the interview will take place and the telephone number that you can call in case you get lost or you are late for the meeting for objective reasons. Make sure you have printed a CV and a letter of intent, as well as some recommendations from former employers or collaborators. Come on time, come 10 minutes before the interview, make sure you don't miss the scheduled time. Be respectful, keep eye contact and smile. Listen carefully, you don't have to talk to the interviewer without letting him finish his questions and ideas. Answer questions. There are many candidates who answer completely different questions, but also ask questions, both about the role you will play if you are employed and about the company's long-term plans. Stay away from the generalities and give examples. Go from "I am a good member of the team" to "a year ago when I was part of team X, I worked on a project Y where I played a key role." What you need to do is the day before the interview, prepare your outfit, accessories, shoes, bag, check online or go to the address where the interview will take place. You can review the answers to the most frequently asked questions of the interviewers. Go to bed at a decent time to be sure that in the morning of the interview, you will not be tired. In the morning of the interview, prepare a healthy breakfast. You have to arrive 10-15 minutes earlier. Smile. Adopt a friendly attitude, both when interacting with the reception staff. Hang up or shut up before the interview. It's the tapes of the classic face-to-face interview. A brief introduction or when the interviewer and the candidate meet. The latter explains the context that led to the job competition. Preliminary questions to adapt to the atmosphere and help you relax. The interviewer will ask you some introductory questions such as, tell me something about yourself, or where did you find the ad for this job? And a few minutes for the presentation, a moment that belongs to the candidate who now has the opportunity to introduce himself and go through a short history of his professional achievements. Central questions from the employer who is now trying to test the candidate's skills and experience, the reason why the candidate wants a new job, what led him to focus on this company, etc. Situational questions refer to situations in the past which the employee has successfully solved, or on the contrary, to hypothetical cases and how he would solve them now. Ask specialist questions that involve techniques about the field you want to work in. Questions about the company refers to the company objectives, the strategy applied, what awards it receives, general information that can be found on the company website. The brain teaser questions to which there is no right or wrong answer. The interviewer wants to see how you think and how you react promptly. The candidate's questions end the job interview and are no less important than those asked by the employer. The candidate has the opportunity to stand out through a few well-directed questions, which demonstrate his interest in the company and the fact that he documented his activity before appearing for the interview. Mistakes to avoid during the job interview. Your phone rings. Turn it off or turn it off in silence. Nonverbal language. The way you hold hands or the way you look at the interviewer says a lot about you. Make sure you don't have an arrogant attitude. This can be corrected with the help of a sample interview with a friend. You speak ill or for former colleagues or your former employee. No matter how you got along with your former colleagues or how you left things, do not speak ill of them and do not lie about the story of past dramas. Be honest. He says you didn't integrate and moved on. Inadequate clothing. Human resources specialist rejected the candidate from the moment they saw him because of the way he was dressed. Forget about asking questions about the company. You need to ask some general questions that shows the person in front of you that you want to work there. You are to focused on the financial aspect. The salary matters, but it's not the sure thing for which you choose to work in a company. The relationship with colleagues, the possibilities for professional development matter. To appear at the interview without being previously prepared. This means knowing the most important information about the company and the industry in which it operates and knowing the information in your resume. What to do after the interview? You need to call or send a thank you email or clarify certain things that might have been harder to understand in the interview. Such an attitude shows that you are motivated to get the job and that you care. Make a list of things that have gone well and need to be improved. Okay. So this is the end of the course. See you at the next one. Goodbye.